If you and your partner have not been able to conceive a pregnancy, you should each have diagnostic testing. But which test should you have? Stay tuned. Understanding infertility testing is not difficult and should not be that expensive. Let's talk about male testing first, since that is a quick and easy talk. All men should have a test called a semen analysis. This is a test in which men collect a semen specimen into a cup. We then inspect it under the microscope. The two most important things to look for are the number of sperm, called sperm concentration, and the movement of sperm, called motility. A third characteristic of sperm is their shape and appearance. This is called morphology. There has been concern in the past about men who have lots of abnormally shaped sperm, but recent studies suggest that this may not be important. If you want a deeper dive into sperm morphology, watch this episode. We do not recommend sperm tests that you do at home or order online. You may hear about many other types of sperm testing. These tests are expensive and unproven. Avoid them. There are several important tests for women who have not been able to conceive. I will describe these in no particular order of importance. To conceive, a woman must ovulate. Testing to document ovulation can be performed in several ways. Nearly all women who are having regular menstrual cycles every month are ovulating. On the other hand, nearly all women with infrequent periods are not ovulating or not ovulating often. These days, most women will purchase a kit to test for ovulation at home. With these kits, you will check your urine for the hormone LH, which triggers release of the egg from the ovary. If your test starts out negative and turns positive, that is a highly accurate indicator that you are about to ovulate. Another method for determining ovulation is to track the consistency of your cervical mucus. If you see that your vaginal discharge changes from thick, sticky, and white to thin, slippery, and clear, and back again, it is likely that you are ovulating. In fact, studies show that having intercourse during the time that it is thin and clear can improve your odds for pregnancy. For more about cervical mucus, watch this video. Your doctor can also verify ovulation by doing a blood test to look at the hormone progesterone in your blood. Progesterone levels are low before you ovulate and high after. The timing of this blood test is important. Watch this video to learn more about measuring progesterone correctly. We do not recommend using tests to check your urine for progesterone metabolites. These tests are more expensive and don't offer any more information than the easier, less expensive tests for LH. Another essential test for infertile women is an examination of the uterus and fallopian tubes. Blocked fallopian tubes will prevent you from becoming pregnant naturally. The easiest and most accurate method to determine if your fallopian tubes are blocked is with an X-ray test called a hysterosalpingogram, or HSG. This test is performed by placing a catheter into the uterus and squirting fluid inside. The fluid, which is called contrast, shows up on X-ray. If there is no blockage, you can see the fluid flowing through the tubes and out the other end. If your tubes are blocked, the fluid flows up to the point of the blockage and then stops. One nice thing about this test is that a fertility doctor can often open blocked fallopian tubes during the test. Other tests, like an ultrasound with salt water squirted inside, do not give images of the fallopian tube and do not allow for simultaneous treatment if blockages are found. Another option for diagnosing blocked tubes is to perform a surgical procedure called a laparoscopy. Although accurate, this is a much more expensive and invasive option that most people don't need. The HSG will also identify abnormalities in the shape of your uterus or any growths or masses inside the uterine cavity. It does not show the ovaries. To identify problems like ovarian cysts, an ultrasound should be performed. Finally, there are a variety of blood tests that may give clues to problems that might be interfering with conception. These include tests to estimate the number of eggs remaining in the ovaries, problems with the function of your thyroid, evidence for infection, and vitamin D deficiencies. If you complete all this testing and the results are normal, you have unexplained infertility. There are a variety of treatments that can increase your chance for conceiving with unexplained infertility. Check out some of our other videos to learn more about them. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.